Our message today is a follow-up from the previous Sunday. And you may want to open your Bibles to Ephesians chapter 4 as well. Ephesians chapter 4, verses 1 through 6. We'll be reading from our Bibles there. And the message comes from Psalms 33, 1 through 22, but we're only going to go through the first 10 verses for the main point. If you remember in Psalm 32, David is saying that we should seek forgiveness. And at the end of chapter 32, verse 11, be glad in the Lord and rejoice, you righteous, and shout for joy, all you upright in heart. In Psalm 31, 1 through 20, or 1 through 10, rejoice in the Lord, O you righteous, for praise from the upright is beautiful. Praise the Lord with the harp. Make melody to him with an instrument of 10 strings. Sing to him a new song. Play skillfully with a short shout of joy. For the word of the Lord is right, and all his work is done in truth. He loves righteousness and justice. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. By the word of the Lord, the heavens were made, and all the hosts of them by the breath of his mouth. He gathers the waters of the sea together as a heap. He lays up the deep in the storehouses. Let all the earth fear the Lord. Let the inhabitants of the world stand in awe of him. For he spoke, and it was done. He commanded, and it stood fast. The Lord brings the counsel of the nations to nothing. He makes the plans of the people of no effect. I entitled this A Call to Worship because once we seek forgiveness, we are so full of joy. We have no reason not to say, thank you, Lord. We have no reason to say, I don't need you. When we know we do need him. As I said last week, you heard me speak about the need for repentance and seeking forgiveness and accepting the grace of God. This week I would like to speak to you about the need for worship and the recognition of the great power that God has over all, even non-believers. But first I would like to speak to the non-believers this morning. And you've heard me talk about the book, Dark Agenda, The War to Destroy Christian America. In it, it talked about how Christians are blamed for forcing, coercing, and demanding people to accept Jesus Christ as their personal Savior, and how they constantly are offended by the truth that the people speak. That we are the reason that they have taken the teachings of the Bible out of text because of it. Let me assure you that there may be some pastors who may be that forward about it and say things, these kinds of things. But most of the believers I know are just trying to keep you from missing the boat to eternity. We therefore preach the word as it is written, nothing added, nothing taken away, and give you the truth straightforward. Whatever happens to you in the process of hearing these truths is between you and the Holy Spirit, who has moved you to anger or become offended, as some of you say. It is because the Holy Spirit has caused you to realize that there is something in your life that you need to work on. That you are missing in your life. It then becomes up to you to make a choice. Make the change according to the truth and come to light in you. When you're offended, don't take it out on the believer or the pastor. Look inward and deep in the deep parts of your heart, mind, and soul. And then ask yourself, why is this bothering me so much? Those who are offended seem to think that it's easier to lash out than to look inward. But I say to you, look inward rather than lashing out. Why is this bothering you so much? If you lash out at the speaker who offended you by what has angered you and done nothing to change your feelings or that hurt you, then you are like the seed that fell on the rocky soil along the roadside. You heard the truth and you ignored it. And it did not grow in the way the Lord intended it to grow. But you turned your back on him and yourself. When we need to seek forgiveness and look to the Lord for that forgiveness and then receive his forgiveness, we tend to feel great and find it necessary to thank him for the forgiveness and the good feelings of relief that we have achieved. David realized how he was freed from this sin through the Lord's grace and forgiveness. In Psalm 33, we read what he was experiencing and shared how we can grow in our faith through worship. Be glad in the Lord and rejoice, you righteous, and shout for joy, all you upright in heart. See, we become free from those chains of the sinful nature. And so now we shout to the Lord in thanksgiving. We receive a free feeling flow in our hearts, our minds, and our souls that helps us to walk without guilt. He tells us to rejoice and be glad, being grateful. David continues these thoughts in Psalm 33. The Believer's Bible entitled it A New Song, the Lord Creating, and in the Study Bible, The Sovereignty of the Lord Creating and History. Rejoice in the Lord, O you righteous, for praise from the upright is beautiful. Can you praise to the Lord when you have something bothering you that you failed to acknowledge that I need forgiveness for this? Are you that free to worship God when you have this burden? Praise the Lord with a harp. Make a melody. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Thank you, Lord, for making me whole. This is what we do when God has put us in the right mind and we've allowed Him. Know what I said? We allowed Him to let Him do it to us. We let go of it and give it all to Him. This is what David did. He acknowledged his failure. And he said, Lord, forgive me. What have we to acknowledge and seek His forgiveness for? Sing Him a new song. It doesn't even have to be a written song. It can be one from your heart saying, I love You, Lord. Thank You for all You've done for me. And I do it every day. Play skillfully with a shout of joy. For the word of the Lord is right, and all His work is done in truth. There's nothing false about it. You don't believe it? Try it. Ask Him for forgiveness and see how you feel when He relieves you of that pain and suffering of the sin that you hung on to for so long. I remember that first day when I accepted Jesus Christ that evening. I was a wailing baby. And there's nothing wrong with a man crying. When you stand in front of the Lord, bowed, saying, forgive me, Lord. I can't carry this anymore. David is saying, rejoice and sing praises to the Lord with a harp. I don't know about you, but I've tried playing the piano. My fingers ain't limber enough for that. I've tried it on several different occasions with the keyboard at home. It went back downstairs in about 20 minutes of practice because I just couldn't. I got frustrated with it. My fingers don't move that fast. I guess I could do the one finger thing. But you can play, you can sing the song from your heart. The instruments can be playing in your mind. But you can sing and rejoice in the Lord for what He's done for you. And when you're done with that, then you can go and do God's will. A good example that follows this is Ephesians in chapter 4, verses 1 following. Believer's commentary states this about that part of it. It emphasizes the unity of the body of God's plan for its growth to maturity. See, once we've accepted Jesus Christ, once we've asked forgiveness of our sins, just as David has done, and we sing to the Lord, now the Lord has a project for us. If we are believers, as Paul has become, we too are a prisoner as a believer in this world. We are tortured and tested, not by the Lord God, but by the evil of this world. Think about it. How will we respond to these treacherous deeds of the evil one and his army? How will we handle it? Ephesians 4:1-6 says this, I, therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you to walk worthy of the calling with which you were called, with all lowliness and gentleness and long-suffering, bearing with one another in love, enduring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one spirit, just as you were called in one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. If we are singing a new song and worshiping the Lord and serving Him as we are called to do, we will be in right step with Him. And we will be in step with Paul, what Paul is saying here. When we come to worship our Savior Christ Jesus and the Father of creation, we are in step with growing with Him and by Him. Or in Him and by Him. David says to come and sing a new song. Rejoice in the grace of God. Paul says we should come together in unity of one body, one spirit, one hope, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all. What do you take away from that? There is only one God. It is not the God of money. It is not the God of things that we possess. It is the God of creation. The one who created you and me in His image. And no matter how we try it, we cannot defy it. We can deny it. But how long will you exist in that mode? How long will you be happy in that mode? Trust me, you will be miserable. The bottom line here is I do not want people to be mad at me for spreading the good news of salvation and a better life. I prefer that you would listen. If it makes you upset, please check yourself. Why is it upset you? If you are upset by what you have heard today, don't lash out or take heart. Don't be upset and lash out. Take heart, as Mary did. And ponder these things. If it has stirred questions in your mind that need answers, call your pastor or me. I can be reached at 308-430-2868. I'd be glad to help you better understand if it be your will. And above all, do not let the sun go down on your frustration about it or anything else that has troubled you without finding the answers to the questions. Ask the Lord God to help you with understanding. We are warned or told and advised in the Bible that if you are angry about something or with someone, to get it talked out, to get an understanding before you go to bed. It goes the same way with Scripture. If you are angered about it, you need to talk to somebody to get some better understanding, or better yet, ask God yourself. He will come to you, and He will help you understand. You just need to open the Bible and read and ask for understanding with Him.